In today's demonstration, we're going to show you how you can take a sketched freehand 2D image, in this case created in Creo Sketch, and convert it into a solid 3D model using freestyle capability inside Creo Parametric. So let's get started. So to begin with, I'm going to use Trace Sketch capability to bring in that previously created 2D image. Trace Sketch allows me to bring in PNGs, TIFFs, or JPEGs. I can then scale them appropriately. In this case, I'm going to define the width, and I'm going to tell it that I want it to be 350 millimeters wide. That will then scale my image, maintaining all aspect ratio, to get the exact size that I want. I can then position that image accordingly in 3D space. I can also alter the opacity of the image. Now I've done that, I want to start and create the geometry. So I'm going to go into Freestyle. First thing I need to do is select a primitive. In this case, it's going to be a sphere. You'll notice the control mesh that goes around the outside of the sphere. That's actually what I use to manipulate and modify the geometry. So I can select faces, edges, or vertices of the geometry and extrude them. This adds more detail to my control mesh. The more detail I have, the more control I have over the shape. So using the 3D dragger, I can push and pull the shape accordingly. Now the product right now is looking a little bit too chunky, so I'm going to squash it in a little bit. In addition, the product's going to be symmetrical, so I'm going to turn on symmetry. I can simply select the mirror plane that I want, and half my control mesh disappears. The top and bottom ends of the shape, I want to have open. So to do that, I can simply select the faces and delete them. Now that I've got my general outline, I can literally start pushing and pulling on the vertices to get as close to the underlying image as I like. In addition to that, I need to put a hole going through the middle. The hole is what I'm going to have for my hand grip. So to do that, I can simply select the front face of the control mesh, and I want to connect it to the corresponding back face of my mirrored geometry. So to do that, I'm going to select the face and use Mirror Connect. That will punch a hole going through my product. Now that I've got that hole in there, I can then continue to manipulate and refine the shape as I like, getting closer and closer to the underlying image. And very easily pushing and pulling on the dragger, on the 3D dragger, I can get the shape as I want. Now my shape is getting closer to how I want it, I need to now go and start and do some further refinement on it. So I'm going to push and pull to get the handle as smooth as I want. In addition to this, I need to add some control or some geometry at the front end that is going to house the rotor for the vacuum cleaner. So to do that, again, I can select the front face and I can simply use the extrude command to add further geometry to it. This will expand out my geometry and give me a nice area at the front to house the rotor. To finish off the design in this case, at the back end, I need to add some further geometry to give a lip at the back. So I can select the faces and offset each face normal to each other to expand the shape out. In addition to that, I want again some hard edges around that. So to finish it off, I can crease those edges. My 3D shape is now pretty much done. So what I'm going to do now is add some fillets to it to give it some further definition. Now that I've done that, I can go in and analyze the shape, put a reflection analysis on it just to see how smooth the geometry is. And you can see how perfectly the reflection lines flow across my geometry. To finish this design off now, all I need to do is thicken it. So using regular Creo Parametric commands, I can select the quilt that has been created and thicken them. To finish off, I might want to do a design change. Design changes always come along. In this case, I want to change the overall style of the product, and I want to add a nice character line going across the top of the product. So again, I can select edges of my control mesh, and I can crease them. And then finally, tweak the shape. Maybe I want to change the overall profile of the shape, or the overall angle of the shape. It's just a case of dragging, selecting the vertices, dragging them using the 3D dragger, and I've now got a completely new design. Thank you.